Hey guys, in this Let's Build series, we're going to create an A-star visualiser where the network can be built and manipulated using the mouse buttons. The edges of the network can be made directional and have weights added to them. To make things easy for the users, we can add a couple of ready-built networks. And for comparison's sake, we can add some of the other algorithms. And of course, we can visualize the algorithms as they run. Or we can step through them action by action. Notice the pseudocode 2 on the left. And of course, you'll want the ability to save and import networks using drag and drop. If you're interested, consider subscribing. And we're going to start out simple by adding the ability to create and drag nodes using the mouse. Okay, let's get started. Create a new project and call it PathViz. Now I have to set up javafx. If you don't know how to do that, I have a video on the process. And I'll just run it to make sure it's working. Okay, that's fine. Now the first thing I want to do is to change the window title to PathViz. And next I want to change the grid pane to a border pane. And in the center, I want to add an anchor pane. This will be our graph area. And I'll make it blue. And I want the graph to respond to mouse press events. Now in the controller, I want to import the graph. Okay, now whenever the user clicks on the graph, I want to create a vertex, and that vertex will be represented by just a normal button. And the button's location should be wherever they clicked on the screen. And let's test that. Okay, so what I actually want is for the button to be centered on where I click. So I'm going to have to translate it to the left by width divided by 2, and I'm going to have to move it up by height divided by 2. Okay, that's what I wanted. So the reason that I'm binding to width property instead of just simply calling getWidth is because a node's width is set by the layout manager when it's added to a parent such as anchor pane. If I was to call getWidth at this point, it would just return 0 because it hasn't been added yet. Next, I want to set up the drag capability. All that we'll do in here is update the vertex's location. So we need to know its current location. Add to it the new mouse location. And we also need to add the translation. There we go. Something I want is that when a node is dragged, it should jump to the front instead of moving behind like this. So the vertex should move to the front when a drag event is detected. There we go. Okay, thanks for watching, guys, and I'll see you next time.